coverage of the St. John Parish deputies who were ambushed for the second time this week. The St. John Parish Sheriff's Office is laying one of its own to rest. Services for Deputy Brandon Neilsen drew officers from across the state. WDSU reporter Gina Swanson was there for the tribute.
The community gathered to pay its last respects to St. John the Baptist Parish Deputy Brandon Neilsen. He was killed in the line of duty, and people here say he'll always be remembered as a hero. Just as the clock struck noon Wednesday, the flag-draped casket of Deputy Brandon Neilsen made its way through a corridor of officers. A final salute to a man who took his final breath protecting others. Killed in what police describe as an ambush last week, now honored at the memorial for fallen officers.
He was one of the best, and you know, Brandon, it wasn't just about being an officer, it was really about being something special to the community.
And the community seemed to hold its breath for a moment as they still grapple with this tragedy.
Ready!
It was a full complement of honors for Deputy Neilsen. Bagpipes played Amazing Grace. There was a 21-gun salute. Friends and family wore little bandages, an idea from Neilsen's young daughter to help with the grieving.
And their daughter, Lily, six, took one of these band-aids and put it on her heart and said, "This is a magical band-aid and it'll help your heart, Mommy."
And a wonderful father. A wonderful dad, wonderful officer, and always had a very good sense of humor.
And a sense of service. Neilsen was assigned to the motorcycle division, something his family members say he always wanted to do since he was a boy.
There was a show called Chips, and a couple main characters were Ponch and John, and we used to ride our bicycles around the neighborhood and do power slides and act like we were chasing bad guys.
And last week, the bad guys killed Neilsen and another deputy, injured two more, and left the community stunned.
And to receive that call from the sheriff the morning of the tragedy was, it shook me to my core.
There's no doubt that the days ahead will be difficult for the community. Deputies leaned on one another for support, and for this officer who loved motorcycles, there was one last ride as the sheriff's department lays one more deputy to rest. Neilsen had been a St. John deputy for just under 2 years. He leaves behind a wife and 5 children. We're on your side. I'm Gina Swanson. Back to you.
After the services, there was a private burial for Neilsen. Before becoming a St. John Parish deputy, Brandon Neilsen worked as a deputy in Jefferson Parish for more than 4 years.